Hi everyone, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to talk about how to reverse paths in Illustrator. It's a little bit of an advanced technique, and you probably won't need to do this unless you're doing it for animation reasons. So we're going to go over a lot of different ways to get this done. All right, let's get started. So we have a few different lines and full paths that I've created with the pen tool. I'm going to just add arrowheads on this so you can see which way the line is going now. If you have an open path, you can just select it, hit P for the pen tool, which is right up here, and then just click on the first point you created, and it'll switch to the direction of the path. If you have a closed shape that you created with the pen tool, first click on it, then go to Object, Compound Path, Make. Next, we'll open our Attributes panel, so Window, Attributes. And if you can't see everything here, make sure you come up to the flyout and then show the things that are hidden. And we'll look at this second little button set. You can reverse the path right here. Now, another way to do this is to go to Object, Path, Reverse Path Direction. And you won't see a change here because this is just a solid stroke. So even though it is switching directions, you can't tell right now. If you want to reverse the direction of a brush, select it, we'll go to Object, Path, Reverse Path Direction. That put the thicker part of the brush over on the other side. This is another closed path. If I hit Command Y, you can see it's just 4 points that are closed. I'll hit Command Y again, and we'll do the same thing. Object, Path, Reverse Path Direction. You can also do this a little easier on something that has a stroke profile. If you open your stroke palette by going to Window, Stroke, make sure you're able to see everything here by going to the stroke flyout and choosing Show Options. And come down here to the profile. And here, this little button will flip it. That also goes for a path that you created with the Width tool. If we hit Shift W to get to the Width tool, and we change this like this, make some edits to it. You can see it update here in the profile, and then you can switch it to the other side if you want. All right, that's my video for this week. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please click on the like button, and I'll see you next week with another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.